Hey y'all, Texas Beekeeper here. Today we're checking up on the solar wax melter that we built the other day. Have put some wax out here. I actually brought some in, already one batch, and now we've got a little bit more that's on there right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all how it turned out and a couple of mods that I made that weren't shown in the video, but I did mention them. And I'll show y'all how clean the wax came out and let y'all decide for yourself if it's something you want to do. Thank y'all. All right, so here's the wax melter. Like I said, temporarily I was going to just set the plexiglass on here, and the first day we had a pretty good strong wind and this thing got knocked off. So since then I've put some rocks on the corners just to hold it down. Like I said, I'm still debating about whether or not to build a larger box to hold the bigger paint tray or not. But for now, this is working. I may, if I don't do that, then I'll build a frame and latch and hinge it. So that's one thing. Here's the glass. So as you can see, we've got all the sludge here. The wax did separate out. Looks like it filtered through there fine. That's hot too, so. Oh yeah, that is hot. So we'll go ahead and pull that out and let y'all see here the rest. So another thing that I did is I put Reflectix on the inside just to kind of help spread the heat around, and that seems to have done pretty good. And I attached the 2x4 in the bottom. So now I no longer have to worry about this moving around. And now we're getting into the bottom chamber. So I wanted this to stay a little cooler, but it looks like with that, you're sacrificing the wax flowing, which is fine. It's very clean, real clean wax, which is great. So I don't know if y'all can just see how clean that is, but that looks awesome. It really did a good job filtering it, and I think I'll sacrifice the nice brick. I mean, I can always throw this in something. Here's some other wax that I already pulled out and forgot to film, but I'll throw this. I can throw this in a silicone pan and put it in the oven just to the melting point and get it to level out, if that's a big deal. It's not though. All we really wanna do is measure it out for stuff like lip balms or melt it for candles or whatnot. So I don't need it to be in a nice, nice brick, because I'm not selling wax, at least not now. And honestly, probably not ever, unless people start getting better prices for it. It's just, can make a lot more off of it, in my opinion, using it yourself or using it for your bees. But so, you know, a little wet still, or not completely solid, but overall I'm pleased with it. I bought this silicone pan that I'm going to start using. So I'll just put that right there in place of this. It's a little wider, not quite as deep, but I think it's going to be fine. If the coolness down below starts to be a problem, what I may do is open this up a little more and go that route. What I was trying to do was make it to where the pan couldn't slip down in, and you know, I may still be able to leave like a tab or something there on this to keep that from happening. But for now, I'm pleased. You know, probably wish it would flow a little bit more before cooling, so I may still try to tweak with that. But I mean, this is, y'all, this is clean wax. That looks great. I mean, any dirt that's on here is probably from my fingers, but that looks great. So we can definitely use that as is where before, man, I was having a hard time getting it to come clean. So this is really great. But yeah, so now I've got this, sorry for the camera bump. Now I've got this bottom attached on here. So all I have to do is pick it up, lay that down. And all I did was use staples for this too. I just put a couple of staples for the Reflectex. Just cut it. And I mean, it's just shooting around some radiant rays in there, keeping it hot. And it seems to have worked really well, because there was a good deal of, oh, this is already cool to the touch. That this was hot as can be a little bit ago. But yeah, so I can just keep that right there. Like I said, I may open up that some just to try to keep a little bit more heat down below to see if it'll melt it a little more. I'm worried that if it, you know, starts cooling too much, those stalagmites, they're gonna just get in the way of the wax dripping. But for now, that hasn't been a problem. And I mean, if you come out and pull your wax, you'll be fine. But that's we probably had half a pound before, so we're probably at, I'd say maybe 3/4 of a pound of wax. So, you know, not a ton. I didn't have a whole lot saved up, but very pleased with this. This sludge there is great. That's gonna be good for making some fire starters or something. So overall, pretty pleased with the results. Again, the one downside is it's getting a little cooler than I planned. I didn't think it would be that cool to keep the wax from leveling out, but I'm sure there's stuff we can do to try to help that. Maybe direct some mirrors down there or something. I don't know. But then we start getting into the non-simple. So for now though, I'm very pleased. And I do think that, you know, if you're looking for a easy to make wax melter, this is pretty easy. It doesn't get much more simple than buying a paint pan, using hive bodies that you already have, and drilling a couple holes. I mean, it's pretty easy to make. So hopefully y'all found it useful. Hopefully y'all are pleased with the results. That filter is still draining. I mean, so I don't see any reason yet to change it out. I'd say if you start seeing a lot of wax collecting there, or you start getting dirty wax, then maybe swap that out. But for now, we're getting good clean wax. I'm really pleased with that. My wife's gonna really be happy with that for making stuff. So thank y'all for watching. Have a good weekend. Hopefully this will post Friday the 17th. And so y'all have a good weekend. Appreciate y'all watching. If you found this useful, please like and subscribe, hit the notification bell, leave a comment, let me know if anybody's made it. If you've made any alterations, let me know. I'd be interested in hearing what you did. Thank y'all for watching.